My first ever makeup experience was when I was 3 years old. Yup, you heard that right. 3. I'm not talking about just exploring my mum's makeup kit as a child and accidentally applying her lipstick all over my face. I'm talking about professional, full coverage, super heavy dance makeup. I've had that kind of makeup on almost once a month, and as I grew older, I had shows almost every week, sometimes even twice a week. And so, my face was exposed to a lot of products at a very young age. I've constantly been on stage or been on screen. When I started acting in Kulavadu, I had makeup on every single day for at least 26 days a month. You can only imagine how my skin has been and what it's been through. And the only way I've been able to tackle any skin issue is by having a healthy skincare routine. So today I'm going to be taking you through my skincare routine. I am not a dermatologist or an expert to be giving you advice, but I'm only sharing with you what has worked really well with me in the past in just 5 simple steps. So the first step of my skincare routine would be cleansing. Now the cleanser that I use is for my particular skin type, which is generally oily no matter what the season. So I use the Cetaphil Oily Skin Cleanser. It has worked really, really well with my skin. And when I was on a trip to Japan, I found this face scrubber, this electronic face scrubber. It has like 3 different modes, it's speeds, it's fantastic. I use this particularly for my problem area, which is the T-zone. So this area going all the way up to my forehead is generally where I find a lot of oil by the end of the day. So I use this to cleanse my face and it works wonders. I use this only thrice, maybe a week. And yeah, of course, the cleanser every single day, twice a day, morning and evening. This works really well. Quick note about this particular cleanser, it does not lather. So you wouldn't find it to be super foamy on your skin, but it's very, very gentle and very soft on your skin. Works really well, worth giving it a try, but also please know your skin type before you go in for a cleanser. Mine is oily, yours could be dry. So always try to read and understand what concern that the cleanser can address, and only then buy something that works for you. So the second step in my skincare routine would be facial hair removal. I have gotten a lot of questions about how I maintain my brows, and I'll be very honest with you, it's easily been about 3 years since I've hit the parlor to get my eyebrows or upper lip done. I shave them at home, and today I'm going to show you my must-haves to do this at home. It's the Carmesi Facial Razor and the Carmesi Eyebrow Razor. Before you start to shave, always remember to wash and mildly pat some aloe vera or moisturizer. Before I get into actually doing my brows, personally I like to fill them out because I can clearly see where my extras are and then only go into like a neat shape. So I've already filled out my brows now. I'm going to show you how I take out my extras. The Carmesi Eyebrow Razor has a small blade which is angled perfectly to get the most difficult areas. It's also got a shielding tip so you can completely avoid tiny cuts. The area near the eye is very sensitive, so this shielding tip also protects the eye. So the next one would be the facial razor. Of course, this is a personal choice for everyone if you want to keep the hair or not. I like to take off the hair on my cheeks and chin and forehead because I apply a lot of makeup and I really prefer that, you know, it's super smooth and the products sit really well and yeah, they just don't get patchy. This is the Carmesi Facial Razor and it's got a zigzag blade which makes the hair removal super easy and the blade glides on your skin very smoothly. This razor has an anti-slip grip which gives you the perfect angle to hold it and shave. Shaving facial hair is fantastic because it helps you get rid of dead skin. It acts like an exfoliator. There is zero pain and it makes your skin feel so soft. Of course, there's a lot of misconceptions that are attached to this and I'm going to address some right away. No, your hair does not grow back thicker. In fact, the hair texture on your body never changes. What happens when you shave is you take off hair and it grows from the shaft. Unlike waxing, which pulls the hair off right from the root. So when the shaft is cut and it regrows, it'll always seem to be thicker because the hair is naturally tapering in nature. So when you take off just the edges, it is going to be thicker right in the middle, and that's going to grow out. So it might feel like it's thicker, but it is not. Hair does not grow back thicker. The second misconception would be your hair or your skin texture would get rough the more you shave, which is again not true. Your skin in fact feels much softer because, like I said, it's like a mild exfoliator, and when you shave your skin, it kind of clears all the clogged pores. So it's fantastic. It'll only make your skin softer but not rough. Although please keep in mind that if you have severe acne, don't go for a facial razor. So the Carmesi Eyebrow Razor is 315 rupees for 3 in a pack, and their facial razor is 299 rupees for 3 in a pack. Currently, Carmesi is having their 4th anniversary sale, and you can get up to 40% discounts. And with my coupon code DISHA10, you can get an additional 10% discount, and not just on these razor, but all of their products. Don't forget to check out my description box for links below. They're available on Amazon as well. I've honestly loved doing my brows at home, and I feel like it's so convenient. You should definitely give this a shot too, and don't forget to cleanse once you're done. So the next step of my skincare routine would be a serum. The one that I use is by Clarins. It's the Hydra Essential. I experiment a lot when I use serums, and especially during winters, I prefer serums that address dehydrated skin or dull skin. I like a lot of hydration only because it's winter, and I go back to something that addresses oily skin in the beginning of the year. So this one by Clarins is very, very hydrating. It's a water-based serum. And then again, I know a lot of you would prefer not doing this step. It's very convenient to cleanse and immediately jump to a moisturizer. But I feel like steps like a serum in your everyday routine would help the overall health of your skin over a period of time. These don't work overnight. These are very concentrated doses of ingredients that go onto your face and kind of work on the skin's health over a period of time. You wouldn't see this happen overnight. You wouldn't just wake up and be like, wow, I'm so fresh and bright. This kind of works over a period of time, and you need to have the patience for it, but definitely worth investing in a good serum that works for your skin type. The next step of my skincare routine would be a moisturizer. I don't think I need to get into the details of the advantages of a moisturizer. Like I said, even if you don't have steps in between your skincare routine, a moisturizer after you cleanse your face is a must. And the one that I have been using is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. Now, the reason why I'm using a gel base is because I have oily skin. If you don't have oily skin, you can use a cream-based moisturizer. Now, moisturizers also come very well categorized depending on what your skin type is and how it can be addressed in a certain way. So always go for moisturizers that are very, very descriptive of what they do. Read about it and try to understand the skin problems that it can tackle and it can help, and you will definitely see changes in your skin when you start using good products that particularly address your issue. The last step of my skincare routine is a sunscreen, and the sunscreen that I use is by Clinique as well. Now, after the serum, I give it a few seconds to settle in, and I just take a few pumps of the moisturizer and put it all over my face and neck. Don't forget your neck. And after that also settles in after a few seconds, I go in for a sunscreen. I can't stress enough on the fact of how important a sunscreen is for your everyday skin routine. If you're somebody that skips steps and that's just, you know, moisturize and leave the house, it's okay, but I feel like this should be a plus one in your list. No matter what you use or don't use, a sunscreen should be something that you have to apply. And I know it's very confusing when you say sunscreen. It's a very broad subject. So I'm going to be talking about three important parts that would probably help you to begin using sunscreen on a daily basis. So the first question that I'm going to be answering about general sunscreen confusion would be, what is the right SPF for me? If you're somebody that has a lot of indoor activity and has very minimal exposure to the sun, 30 SPF is good for you to start with. And if you're somebody that does have a lot of exposure to the sun, that heads out pretty often, then please go for something that's 60 or above, or 50 or above. Because I feel like we don't realize the kind of damage that the sun's rays could do to us. And we should be very aware that using a sunscreen on a regular basis would help from premature aging, would help from sunburns, would also help from skin cancer. So regular usage of sunscreen is extremely important in any routine of your skincare. So the second question I'm going to be answering about a sunscreen is, can we purchase a sunscreen that is mixed with our foundation or makeup in general, right? So a lot of creams come with they have mentioned that, you know, they have 30 SPF with your foundations or your basic moisturizers. But personally for me, I prefer a standalone sunscreen because I feel like they're much stronger when they're not diluted with a makeup product. So I would suggest again for you to go for a standalone sunscreen and not something that's just put into your moisturizer so you have better coverage. If not, you need to really put your moisturizer in layers and layers over your skin. So the strength of the sunscreen is shown, but go for a standalone. It kind of saves you time and energy and you don't have to layer up too much. Right after moisturizer, go for a sunscreen, finish that up and then leave the house. Now the third question is, do we really need a sunscreen in winters? In fact, 80% of the sun rays can pass through clouds, which clearly tells you how much exposure you have to the sun even during winters, even if it's a cloudy day. If you just see that it is bright outside, if you can see light outside, it's hitting your skin. So it is extremely important for you to kind of cover up, wear good clothes, cover up completely so your skin's not directly exposed to the sun. But for your face, definitely, I feel like during the winters as well, a sunscreen is extremely, extremely important. This is a step that you just can't miss. Your skincare routine depends a lot on your subjective preference, which is why there's no such thing as a set number of products that you might use every single day. But having said that, it's also important to remember that the effectiveness of a good skincare routine depends not just on the quality of products used, but also on the order and technique in which they're applied. If you're new to setting up a skincare routine for yourself, your first step should be understanding and knowing what your skin type is. So you can buy products and follow a set of steps to address the issue of your skin and keep it healthy. Remember, healthy skin is not an overnight process. Give your skin time and love and you'll see it shine.